In the ever-shifting terrain of the modern workplace, a remarkable species has emerged. Adaptable, resilient, terminally online. We call them the Omnisend. Observe. A Google Doc titled final_final_version2_actually_final lies open and untouched. One individual reaches for a mug. It is empty. Again, we must be quiet. Any sudden movement and they migrate to the kitchen. Let's approach with caution and begin our expedition. What we are supposed to be witnessing here is the content editor team, but because we are filming this at lunchtime, they have already migrated to a local canteen for their daily ration. We are supposed to witness the introduction of default text personalization across multiple environments. Once confined to the inner body, fullback text can now be used in subject lines, AB subject lines, SMS messages, and push notifications. It is a small but vital adaptation for survival in the wild inbox. They've also got the newly improved AI subject line generator. Now with guided prompts, green navigation, and a layout that doesn't make you question all of your life choices. A gentle evolution, but a meaningful one. Okay, let's get back to the safety of the studio to break it all down. Follow closely and try not to spook the product team. Be startle easy. Segmentation. In the world of segmentation, the important process has grown more intelligent. Columns now auto-map when using the example template. Navigation is simplified, reducing confusion in the wild. Segments can be renamed mid-import. Tagging has improved in a new finalized step that gives you one last moment to reflect and avoid importing chaos. It's not glamorous, but neither is... Well, actually it is. It is glamorous. Reports. Also, a new report species has appeared. The back-in-stock report helps you track which products are being requested. View demand by variant, seeing which customers are waiting, make better restocking decisions based on actual interest. It's basically supply and demand. It's nature. Store of settings. In a quiet but significant update, API errors are now visible directly within Omnisend. You can now not only manage and generate API keys, but also view real-time issues in a dedicated section and access documentation right where it's needed. A snow shift, but one that brings clarity to an area previously shrouded in... Oh, I think we've been able to track another travel species. Follow me, quit integrations. We are currently in the hunting grounds of the partnerships team. This team is calm, deliberate, and often speaking in acronyms. Two new integrations have entered their ecosystem. First, a fully customizable loyalty program with points, keys, referrals, and rewards. Ideal for turning one-time buyers into people who keep asking about their point balance. And lastly, Elevar Session Enrichment. Elevar helps Omnisend track more on-site behavior, like product views, add to cart, and checkout starts. More events, more automations. More automations, more revenue. The food chain remains intact. But let's not linger. The knit onboarding. And doing onboarding, forget. Ravenous. Usability Improvements. Finally, a number of usability upgrades have quietly made life better across the platform. Brand assets can now be edited directly in the email builder. Pending campaigns are now correctly labeled as scheduled. Automations can be booked, disabled, or deleted, with options to finish or exit flows. Special characters now render properly in reviews. Reviews can be deleted in bulk with a confirmation step for safety. Gradio imports now apply smart tagging, and so on. Each change small, but collectively they shape a calmer, cleaner environment for the Omnisend. And thus concludes our April expedition into the world of Omnisend. Explore them at your own pace, but try lightly. The inbox is a fragile place.